Hi, this is Reiner from Plekker, and I will get you started with our new power-up. The first thing you need to do is to enable the power-up in your team. When you do not already have a Plekker account, you need to sign up to Plekker. If you do, you get a 15-day free trial period. When you sign up, you need to authorize Plekker that it can access your data in Trello. The next step for me is to export my data into Plekker. In this process, I'm also setting up how my cards move from open to completed on my board. In my case, I move them from one list to another. Plekker uses this information to automatically log the actual start and end date to each of my cards and to calculate the time spent on each card. Let's have a look what was added by the power-up. First of all, two board buttons will bring you to the Gantt or the track view in Plekker. Next to that, on the back of the card, you can now add card mirrors, add dependencies between cards, and add plan attributes on your card. When I go to the Gantt chart, I can visually plan the cards of my board. I can drag to add a start and an end date. And I can create dependencies to indicate that one card should start before the other is finished. These changes on the Gantt are automatically synchronized with your Trello board. There are a lot of settings available, for example, to set a filter or to change the order or the color of your Gantt cards. You can also export your Gantt to a picture, a PDF or even MS Project. When you click on Track, you will open your dashboard in Plekker. Dashboards in Plekker are a simple way to get insight in the status of your cards. You can completely customize these dashboards based on the many different widgets available. This is the default dashboard, and you can see that we have all the basic widgets available to support Scrum, Agile, or Waterfall methodology. They are also interactive. For example, if I want to see what are the blocked cards, I can click on the chart and I can see the underlying card. Clicking on the Trello icon will bring me back to Trello. I will now show you what was changed on the back of the card. Let me open this card. You can see that three things are changed. First of all, the plan attributes that are set on the cards in Plekker are now shown in Trello. Secondly, you can see that the dependencies that are set are also shown on the card. And lastly, there are three buttons that allow you to add mirrors, create dependencies, and add plan attributes on your card. You can update plan attributes by clicking on them, for example by changing the duration from 1 week to 2. And you will notice that if I do that, also the end date will be moved by a week. If the plan attribute is not yet set, I can click on the button to add it. For example, to add a traffic light status to Amber, which is now available. I can add a new dependency by clicking on the button. And I can either set cards that need to be finished before this card can start, which is a successor, or I can add dependencies for cards that can start when this card is finished. Clicking on the link allows me to select the card. Dependencies can be deleted by clicking on the delete button. Let me open a second board to show you how the mirror works. So this is my mirror target board, which is also imported in Plekker. And this is the card I want to mirror on this board. I click on the add mirror button. I can select my board and the list to create the mirror. You see that the card is created on the second board. Now, when I update something here, like the title, the change will be reflected in the mirrored card as well. You can set, by clicking Edit Mirror, the attributes that you would like to mirror. What's also interesting is that the progress is mirrored. So, for example, if I move this card from completed to started, then also the card will be updated here. The settings of the power up allows you to select exactly what is visible for the power up. So for example, if I do not want to show these board attributes, and if I only want to show story points, I can go to the power up settings. I can hide the board attributes. I hide mirror and I only show story points. When I now click save, you can see that the board buttons are removed and on the back, I only have the story points available. This way you can completely customize the power up to fit your process. This concludes this video. You can visit the Help Center for more articles, or you can always reach out to us from plekker.com.